for example, in Brazil.
Yeah, that's great. Well, thank you very much for your time, and we're going to go and enjoy all the cabrio and especially the X6 on the track.
Have fun.
Thank you.
Pues ahí tienen toda la información de BMW, lo que está pasando, la expansión que van a tener en México a partir del 2016, donde van a construir esa planta nueva en San Luis Potosí. Todavía no hay los modelos específicos que van a salir de esa planta, pero ya está en marcha, ya está ubicado el lugar donde se va a construir y los trabajos ya están en marcha. Así que ahora vamos a pasar a un poco hablar de la prueba de manejo sobre la BMW X6M. Con el piloto Bill Overly, que es uno de los pilotos de la fábrica de BMW, quien recientemente, por cierto, completó las 24 horas de Daytona y quedó en segundo lugar a solamente 4 segundos del ganador. Algo realmente increíble cuando se toma en cuenta que es una carrera de 24 horas. Así que aquí está Bill Overly, piloto de pruebas o piloto de la fábrica de BMW en el circuito de las Américas en Austin, Texas.
Well, Bill, thank you very much for spending some time here with us at Circuit of the Americas with the new BMW X6M. Not a race car per se, but pretty close, huh?
What's crazy is it weighs more than our race car.
Yeah.
It makes more power than our race car. It's not designed to be a race car, but the problem is it's so good that we have it on a racetrack showing you what it's capable of. It boggles people's mind. When they go around here on the racetrack and they put their foot to the floor and it makes so much traction and so fast, yeah, their jaws just drop.
So can you tell us a little bit about how it's to drive it in this circuit? I mean, this is a very technical track. I mean, this is Formula One racetrack and like 20 turns, very long, kind of 3 miles, something like that. So it's not easy to drive, but this one makes it easy because it has so much technology in it too, right?
People don't realize that BMW shows you some of the technology. If they were to put on a piece of paper all the technology that's in there that's helping you drive, it would be a book. It's incredible. From what I didn't even know, active sway bars,
yeah,
active brakes, active suspension, active steering, so many things that get you in the right direction, keep you from making mistakes, make you look like Ayrton Senna when you're not Ayrton
well,
Senna.
Well, maybe you, not me.
Yeah. But I mean, you point the car somewhere, yeah, and what normally would get somebody in trouble, they never do. They never get to the limit. The limit's so high, yeah, it makes so much grip, but the systems are amazing from keeping you from getting in trouble.
Yeah, so V8, 4.4 liters, 567 horsepower. I mean, that's a lot for a big car, as you were saying. But so what's like top speed? What can you reach here in this track?
Well, I've reached it almost every lap. It is speed limited to 155. Now that little back straightaway, I go and I hit the speed limiter.
Oh, that's amazing.
So 155 miles an hour.
In an SUV.
in an SUV, a sport activity vehicle is what,
yeah,
and then to hit the brakes, and time after time, in the old days, you would have just burned the brakes off.
Yeah.
It's a 2.5-ton car. You would just burn the brakes off. The brakes are so big and so good. Lap after lap, we've done this now for 2 days, given rides from morning till night, and the brakes just are perfect.
Yeah. So you just raced the 24 hours in Daytona with BMW. How was that?
It was great. We prepared for it quite well. Like we did a pre-24-hour race in December to make sure that all our equipment was good. We ran through it with the team. Like it was like a dress rehearsal. Then when we went there, we knew what was going on. We were very good. The car was reliable, and we finished second by, get this, 0.46 seconds off the one. We're almost side by side after 24 hours crossing the line.
Exactly, after 24 hours. What was it, like 700 laps or something like that?
I don't know. It's a lot.
And it's incredible.
Yeah, it's incredible to be that close. And technically, in the old days, technology was such that you had to baby the car to the finish line to make it work. Now, BMW and a lot of the manufacturers have gotten so good that you run this car 100%, and as long as a person doesn't make a mistake, the car will never fail.
Yeah. So you drove the C4 in that race?
Z4, yep.
Yeah. So you have been a little bit more comfortable in this one there. Probably wouldn't finish second, but you have been more comfortable for a 24-hour race.
Yes, this car is very comfortable. Look at everything's a little. I've been lucky enough to be through the BMW X5s, X6s, through all their versions.
Yeah.
They just keep getting them better and better. Now they have new interior. That's even nicer, even better leather. And then you have a new motor, more power, more torque available at a lower RPM and a higher RPM It's everything is just being refined to the best degree.
So you are a professional car driver. I'm not. I mean, I do some of these events, but I try to learn a little bit. So what are a couple of tips for someone who is trying to get some experience and get a little bit better when they have a chance to drive on a racetrack?
Specific to the X6 or just
specific to the X6 and in general, I guess.
Specific to the X6, what people don't realize, it's four-wheel drive. When you turn that car, where normally, and just a rear-wheel drive car, you put your foot down, the rear wheels would spin. You have four wheels to put this big tires to put the power through. Put that, you know, 570 horsepower down much earlier than you think. It's going to yank you off the corner time after time. That's what the X6M. The stopping is great. People don't realize how good it is. Now, racing, it's about being in that seat. Get on that track as much as you can. Yeah. That's the hard part. And refine your skill.
One of the perceptions is that you have to be fast, but that's not necessarily true, right? You don't have to be fast all the time.
Well, okay, so there's two things here. I race in sports car racing, long races, 24 hours long, 12 hours long. Fast keeps you in the car. Like fast, if you're really fast, that's what gets you the job. If you crash, that's what gets you out of the job, right?
Much faster.
Yeah, you have to be fast because there's a lot of guys that are fast, but you have to be perfect. You have to be perfect for 24 hours. Imagine, there's 100 engineers that built our car, designed it, put their blood, sweat, and tears in it, and then when they hand it over to you, and you're in there for your 2, 3, 4 hours of driving, it's a lot on your shoulders, and you have to be spot on. You can't go and crash it or hit somebody or ruin the race. It's a lot, depending
on you. Patience and consistency.
In a 24-hour race, we knew we weren't going to race until 10 o'clock the next day.
Yeah.
Stay out of trouble. I don't even care if you're dead last. We'll get to the front. Sure enough, 10 o'clock came around. A lot of people crashed into each other. Not even, and also like the Porsches crashed into each other and took themselves out, team cars. So you just wait for people to make the dumb mistakes, wait for them to weed themselves out, and then put your head down at about 10 in the morning and just start banging off the fast laps.
Well, I'm going to go now and drive here. I hope I don't make the dumb mistakes.
You will
not.
Thank
you very much for
your time.
This
car will keep you from doing it, but yeah, thanks
for being here. Thank you very much for your time, and very nice talking to you.
Nice talking to you. Thank you.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.